Welcome back. It's time now for She Said, and today we're going to talk about something a little different, and that is a catalog that is kind of sparking some outrage from a group, while a card sparked outrage from a different group, all of it aimed at a store. Seems Urban Outfitters just can't seem to catch a break. Last month, the company was catching heat from gay, lesbian, and transgender groups for a greeting card that used the Jack and Jill rhyme, but took a little too far for some. And this morning, the clothing store's April catalog is now under fire. A group of, they call themselves 1 Million Moms, which some describe as an anti-gay group, is objecting to what an ad inside that catalog shows. It's what the group describes as a steamy kiss between two female models. Take a look at it. Definitely two females kissing, yes. 1 Million Moms says the ad just goes too far because it says the catalog and clothing is clearly geared toward teenagers. On its website, the group says, quote, the content is offensive and inappropriate for a teen who is the company's target customer. Urban Outfitters, though, says it wants to, quote, create a differential type shopping experience, which creates an emotional bond with to the 18 to 30 year old target customer we serve. So it's a little older than maybe the 1 Million Moms thinks. And you may remember that earlier this year, 1 Million Moms said it was going to have its members boycott JCPenney's because the retail chain appointed Ellen DeGeneres as its spokesperson. But after Ellen received massive support from fans all over the world, 1 Million Moms dropped its case. Now, 1 Million Moms is a division of the American Family Association.
Okay.
So, did that ad bother you guys at all?
For me personally, and I don't think it's that it's two women, but I just don't think that, I don't want, if it were me, I wouldn't purchase a card of two people kissing, regardless if it's a male and a female or whatever. I don't really want to see that. I don't have a problem that it's two women if it were a man and a woman. That doesn't bother me.
Mm-hmm. If Urban Outfitters is trying to stand out among a lot of retailers, they're obviously doing a good job. I mean, two controversies in 4 months.
Right.
If they're trying to create buzz, they know the way to do it. They've they've put their name out there, and regardless, you know, what is it that no publicity is bad publicity? I mean, people are talking about it. They're going to look at their catalog. So maybe that's what their marketing division is going for. They're trying to be edgy to get people to talk about them.
I think you see a lot of this stuff out there, whether it's billboards or what, you know, whichever companies or what have you, and just in my home with my children, and I hope to have more, I just, we'll have our standard, our teachings, whatever, they're going to see this everywhere.
Right, it's out there regardless, and if they don't see it in this store, they'll see it somewhere else, right?
And by the age of 18, you know, which is their target, I hope that that conversation has been, you know, already happening, and as a teenager, I hope that conversation.
You've seen Abercrombie and Fitch's.
Yes, they
are racy. I mean, and they've had some controversy over theirs before.
That's true, that's true. I thought we banned this next guest, this next subject.
Well, it's okay because YC brought her up first.
That's right.
Technically do it.
She broke the ice.
Yeah.
Okay, okay. Who are we talking about? Kim Kardashian.
That's right.
She conquered business, reality TV, and every cover of every tabloid, it seems, but she wants a little more?
Yeah, it looks like our favorite reality star is now looking for a future in politics. Yeah.
No.
Kim revealed her plans during an upcoming episode of Chloe and Lamar. In it, she expresses an interest in a run for office because her hometown is largely Armenian. Check it out.
I decided I'm going to run for the mayor of Glendale. So for real.
For real. But the only problem with that, for real, Glendale doesn't elect a mayor. The position is appointed through city council, a council in which the members had some choice words for Kim when they heard about her declaration. They're encouraging her to do a little research about the position and not rely on perceived support base. You don't just drop into this job, said one councilman. He encouraged Kim to start fielding interest by attending an upcoming Armenian genocide commemoration in Glendale. What do you guys think? You think she's just talking? It's just something else to talk about to get headlines or...
I want to know, has she ever really been to a city or town council meeting? Does she know Robert's rules of order?
No, she doesn't know you don't run for it. They kind of pick you out.
She obviously had not done her research. Right.
But to give her credit, as far as the whole Armenian community is concerned, she is well connected and knows her heritage and history a lot, and is an advocate for certain events. So no shot at her as far as that's concerned, but whatever. So should we reenact the band? No, our band.
I think they're fun to talk about.
Yeah, actually.
I know.
I didn't even know Chloe and Lamar had their own show, though.
Oh, girl, it's like season three.
See, this is why we need to talk about this.
How are there, though? There's the Keeping Up with Kardashians, Chloe and Lamar.
Kim and Courtney take New York. Chloe
they also did Miami.
Take Miami.
Okay.
God, that's like five.
I have never watched an entire episode.
I haven't either. That's why I don't know.
Oh, well. It is what it is.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you. Katie has just ruined my morning.
This is good stuff.
Yeah, but I love butter. And now, you know, I know if I ate a whole stick, I'd get sick.
Right. I mean, I don't think many people would say I'm going to eat a stick of butter or order it as like a side entree or anything. Right. But it wouldn't taste good. We know better. There are 92 grams of fat in one stick of butter. That's more than what's recommended we eat in one day to maintain a healthy diet. But there are actually some foods that have more grams of fat than a stick of butter, and it might surprise you. Mm. Okay, so I just want to kind of go over these.
Okay.
Fish and chips. Do you guys like fish and chips?
Yeah. Mm.
Yes. So apparently the meal from Applebee's has 138 grams of fat.
Nuh-uh.
Isn't that crazy? I'm not very organized. Okay. Sneaky salads. And I know that they always say that salads can really add up quickly,
right?
Because you have, you know, bacon and cheese and dressing and all of this. The IHOP has a crispy chicken salad that has many of the no-nos: fried chicken, bacon, tons of cheese, egg, garlic bread, heavy dressing, 95 grams of fat. I know, isn't that crazy? Shakes. Do you guys like shakes?
I love shakes.
I know the bad news about this, though, already. I don't want to hear it, though.
I'm going to tell you anyway. Cold Stone Creamery PB&C shake comes in at 131 grams of fat. This is what the best part is. Peanut butter, ice cream, chocolate.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. I know. So, but this is crazy. 68 strips of bacon.
In equivalent to a milkshake?
Yes. I think I would rather have the bacon myself.
You're going to go.
You got to go big, right? And then they said some of the other ones are, you know, quesadillas, fried chicken meals, burgers with tons and tons of toppings, like the fried onion rings and all this stuff.
But I think it's all, don't you think it's back to portion control?
Because
I bet if we saw that basket of fish and chips, it's like the size, you know, of a boat.
Right. I'd try to eat all of it.
I think if you have a small milkshake every now and then, I think it's okay.
Yes.
I mean, you don't want the super gulp size of your head milkshake and then every
to go with your fish and chips.
All in moderation.
I'm gonna go.